What's up guys, today I'm gonna show you how I color grade my videos and we are turning this into that. Let's right jump in into Premiere Pro and start with this shot from my Sony A6000, and we need to open the color panel and also the Lumetri scopes. And don't worry if you don't have them, just click on window and open Lumetri scopes. Therefore we have different scopes you can turn it on and off with this little tool toggle. And we need the waveform, what tells you the darkest and the brightest parts of your video. The RGB form, which tells you a color imbalance, basically like your white balance check. And also the vector scope, what tells you general what colors are in your shot. And I'm going to start to pull the blacks a little bit down about 0 and pull up the whites a little bit to about 100. Turn down the shadows a little bit and also bumping up the highlights. And then I checked my white balance, which is pretty accurate. As you can see, when I move the slider, the colors are shifting. And what I basically do, I tip on this little pipette and click on a white spot in the shot and boom, you have the perfect white balance. Sometimes it's not that accurate, but it seems like it's pretty good in this shot. I also bump up the saturation a little bit, and with the FX toggle, you can see what it was before and after your color correction. And now we're gonna jump into the fun part of this video, creating the cinematic look. Therefore, you need to go to the project panel, create a new adjustment layer. I'm gonna rename it to look just for my convenience. And then I'm gonna drag and drop it above my video file, resize it a little bit. And then I'm gonna go to the effects panel. If you can't find it, it's also in window and then effects. Type in Lumetri color and also drag and drop it on the adjustment layer. After that is done, we jump into the RGB curve, what controls the shadows and highlights of your shot. And what I basically do is I'm gonna set 3 dots and pull down the first one for shadows and pull down the second one for midtones and bump up the last one for highlights to create kind of an S shape. And now the magic happens. We jump into the HSL secondary, pick this little pipette eyedropper and select the color we want to change in the video, or you can select the color itself. I'm gonna select blue because I want to change the blue tone with the sliders, and everything what is white in the picture is not affected when we change the color. So you have to decide what you want to change in your shot and play with the sliders a little bit. I want to mainly change the street and the sky, so I try to white out the truck. I'm going to denoise it a little bit and bump up the blur. And then I'm gonna change the color. As you can see, I'm gonna move to more like a tealish look, and you see in the picture how the colors are changing. I think just a little bit more, that looks right. I'm gonna bring up the contrast and desaturate it just a tiny bit because I think it's a little bit too vibrant. I think that looks quite right. And now we also changed the color of our shadows, and we want clean black shadows. So we're gonna jump right back to the hue and saturation curves and scroll down to luma versus saturation and pull down the left side to get like this clean black shadows. And for the last part, we go to the creative tab. I'm gonna sharp up the video just a little bit and give it a bit more saturation and vibrance. And boom, we have this cinematic looking shot. You can toggle it on and off with the FX toggle. And I think that looks pretty dope.
Thanks for watching guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know if you want to see more of those videos. You can also check out my preset pack down in the description. And I also want to thank Epidemic Sound. That's where I get almost all my sound effects and music from. You can check it out totally free for 30 days. So stay tuned.